In this video, we will learn about Russia's investment of $19 billion into Iraq's energy sector and exploring Iraq's booming new e-payment system. We will also take a look at the Indian rupee as a short-term investment. Now, here's some interesting news. Russia has channeled $19 billion into Iraq's energy sector, changing the game. In a landmark announcement during the 80th anniversary of diplomatic relations between Russia and Iraq, Russian Foreign Minister Sergei Lavrov revealed that Russia has invested over $19 billion in Iraq's energy sector. Major Russian oil companies, Lukoil, Gazprom-Neft, and Rosneft, are at the forefront of this initiative, playing a crucial role in developing Iraq's energy infrastructure. The investment not only aims to enhance Iraq's economic growth but also reflects Russia's strategic interests in the Middle East. This $19 billion investment marks a significant chapter in the long-standing relationship between the two countries, promising mutual benefits and a strengthened alliance. Iraq just hit $1.52 billion in digital transactions last month. Here's why this matters. The Iraqi Private Banks League's director, Ali Tarek, announced this impressive milestone, highlighting the nation's shift towards digital transactions. With about 20 million credit and debit cards in circulation, nearly half of Iraq's population is embracing e-payments. The Central Bank of Iraq is pushing this trend further by partnering with international consultants Oliver Wyman to beef up the banking infrastructure. They're also setting up a national company to regulate these e-payment systems, ensuring your transactions are safe and reliable. Why does this matter to you? The surge in e-payments signals a more inclusive financial future for Iraq, where quick and secure transactions become the norm. So, if you're still relying on cash, it might be time to go digital. And herein lies the issue for IQD investors outside of the country. We do not yet have access to banking services. Guys, it's time to find an honest Iraqi broker who can facilitate banking access for the group. If you've been following the currency markets, you might have noticed the Indian rupee has been depreciating at around 3% per year for the past two decades. But with India emerging as a manufacturing powerhouse and holding robust forex reserves, could this trend be changing? Let's break it down. As you know, just like with the Iraqi dinar, there are seven basic factors that help determine the currency rate of any currency: inflation, interest rates, terms of trade, political stability, balance of payments, national debt, and recession. Global events also have a significant impact. For instance, a global economic slowdown can reduce demand for Indian exports, which puts downward pressure on the rupee. On the flip side, a strong global economy can boost export earnings and strengthen the currency. Another major factor, especially for Iraq, is the fluctuation in crude oil prices. India is a major importer of crude oil, so rising oil prices can widen the country's current account deficit, putting additional pressure on the rupee. It's essential to keep an eye on these external factors to assess potential risks and opportunities, seeking expert advice and conducting thorough research before making any investment decisions is crucial. India's position as a growing manufacturing hub and its strong forex reserves provide a solid foundation that could help the rupee buck its long-term depreciation trend. So, is the Indian rupee a good investment? It depends on various factors, so buying and holding the Indian rupee may be a wise short-term investment. We know India ranks among the world-leading countries exporting diamonds, jewelry, and refined petroleum. And now, India is fast becoming a global manufacturing hub. Do your research.